الحمد لله ولي التوفيق، والحمد لله الذي بنعمته وجلاله تتم الصالحات. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، على آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. قبل أن نشرع في المقصود، سأعطي 10 دقائق حول من هو المبتلى، من هو المبتلى ومن هو المعافى.
بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Before we begin the topic of the night, I will give about 10 minutes to describe the one who is truly afflicted today. Who are the ones who are truly sick, who are going through a calamity? Who is the one who is healthy and who is the one who is sick? Who is the one who is safe? Who is the one who is safe and who is the one who is afflicted? It is mentioned in the hadith that if you see the people who are being afflicted, ask Allah's protection, ask Allah for safety.
اعتقاد السامعين أن من وجد واحدا في الشارع مريضا يقول اللهم عافنا ولا تبتلنا.
The people who hear this hadith think that this hadith just refers to when you see somebody in the street who is injured, that you say, oh Allah, protect us. That you see somebody who is homeless, that you say, oh Allah, protect us. That you see somebody who is sick, oh Allah, protect us.
ولكنه إذا وجد كافرا أو فاسقا أو مبتلا في دينه لا يقول اللهم عافنا ولا تبتلنا.
But then, if they see a person who is afflicted in their belief, in their faith, who is a disbeliever or a hypocrite, they do not say, oh Allah, protect us and save us.
هذا فهم خاطئ.
This is an incorrect understanding.
من دعاء الصالحين اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا.
From the supplication of the righteous, from the dua of the righteous people is, O Allah, do not make our affliction in our deen. And do not make our calamity in our deen.
ولا تجعل مصيبتنا صفي اسكس. اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا.
Nor make this world our greatest concern, nor the extent of our knowledge.
فقد تكون المصائب منحا.
The worldly calamities can be hidden blessings.
وقد يكون الفقر والمرض عافية.
Poverty and illness could be a means of safety from greater calamities.
يقول العلامة محمد مولود في مطرة القلوب وخير أوقاتك وقت تشهد فيه الأشال من إليه يصمد.
محمد مولود said
في مطرة القلوب
in the book Purification of the Heart, مطرة القلوب,
خير أفعال التفضيل.
He said the best of your times as a human being, the best part of your experience here in this world are those times where you witness and you truly feel
تشهد فيه الحاجة والقرب والتجاء,
where you truly feel your great need, where you're put in a situation that you have to flee and turn and run towards Allah for help, meaning the times of calamity, of worldly calamity, those you'll remember as your best moments in this world.
لأن الكريم إذا قربك منه ما ترك شيئا.
Because once the most generous Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings you, the Lord of the worlds, brings you closer to Him, then do you think His reward will be small? That you say, O Allah, protect me, O Allah, help me, and you feel your genuine need and you're supplicating from your heart in that moment, do you think Allah will give you something small and insignificant? It means that Allah will open for you doors of goodness beyond your imagination. Everything from Allah is a great gift. Even when He withholds from you that which you seek from this world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you a gift because He knows the destruction that could come about to you as a result of you getting those things that you desire. And to Allah is the highest example. But we understand from how that a mother must withhold sweets from her child if she wants that kid to be healthy. America, you guys don't like sugar at all. What are you afraid of? You're afraid of getting sick. But what illness is there greater than arrogance and rebellion against the one, the Lord, the insurmountable? What happens to the human being? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that that human being transgresses once you see them feel needless of Allah. That you see him transgressing, going beyond the boundaries, going beyond the boundaries, breaking the boundaries of even what is considered normal for a human being, going outside of even human nature, once you see him feel needless of Allah. As such, the scholars have said, the companions have said, that we were tested and afflicted. We were tested with times of difficulty and we were patient. And we were tested with times of ease and we were not patient. How many afflictions did the companions encounter in the early days of Islam when they were persecuted and exiled and attacked and killed? Because the one who has their hands tied is not like the one who is free. That is why the blessings from Allah require gratitude and patience, not just patience like an affliction.
البلية كل البلية أن ترى غافلا عن الله تعالى هذه أن تكون غافلا عن الله أن ترى غافلا عن الله تعالى.
So the greatest calamity and the person who is truly afflicted is the one who is heedless of Allah, the one who has forgotten his creator. That is the one who is afflicted.
هذه الذي إذا رأيتم فسألوا الله العافية.
That is the one.
يقول محمد مولود رحمه الله تعالى أهل البلاء إذا رأيتم فاسألوا الله عافيته والكملوا قد فسروا أهل البلاء بمن غفل عن ربه سبحانه عز وجل.
So then as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you see the people who are afflicted with calamities, then ask Allah for safety and protection from that calamity.
الكملوا العارفون فسروا ذلك.
And the knowers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the scholars, have said,
ما فسروه بالمريض.
This doesn't necessarily mean, or it doesn't refer to primarily the one who is ill, but it refers primarily to the one who is heedless and forgetful of Allah. The one who has forgotten his Lord, the most exalted and great. That is the one who is afflicted.
كما يقول العلماء اللطف الخفي يوسف عليه السلام أعطاه الله الملك تحت طي السجن.
But as for the one who is going through worldly trials, that person could be actually receiving a great gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, both in this world and the next. As you saw, the subtle blessings that Allah gives through difficulty, such as the Prophet Joseph, Yusuf alayhi salam, peace be upon him, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him a leader of the people.
Abdan masjunan.
Through what? Through being enslaved and imprisoned. He was an imprisoned slave, accused falsely by women.
ما هو المصدر الرئيسي لذلك؟
What was,
ما هي الحكمة بذلك؟
What is the wisdom of that?
اجعلني على خزائن الأرض إني حفيظ عليك.
That what happened, النتيجة. This led to him being النتيجة. Placed in charge of the treasury and the stores of the land.
اجعلني على خزائن الأرض تحت السجن والاتهام بالزنا والعبودية.
He received that worldly blessing and that leadership over the people through what? Through being afflicted by slavery, abandonment, and imprisonment.
اتهام النساء السجن العبودية.
And false accusation, all were the means that Allah chose.
والرمي في البير من إخوته.
The subtle means that Allah chose for him to reach where he reached. And starting with him being thrown into the well by his own brothers.
أول الطريقة إخوانه جعلوه في البير. الثاني مرأة ملكت واتهمت بالزنا. الثالث السجن.
He was thrown into the well by his own brothers.
والرابع السجن.
And then he was sold into slavery. And then he was enslaved by a woman who accused him of assaulting her when she was the one who was assaulting him and he was denying her. And then he was thrown into prison based on these false accusations. That we prepared the land for him and we made him a leader, gave him leadership in the land. That Allah says we grant our mercy to whom we will.
فمعناها البلاء كل البلاء أن ترى غافلا عن الله تعالى أما غير ذلك فإن الحديث الصحيح بين أن أمور المسلم كلها خير عاش بل للمؤمن إن أمره كله خير له خير فإن أصابته نعماء وشكر الله تعالى فذلك خير وإن أصابته ضراء وصبر فذلك خير له وليس ذلك لغير المؤمن.
So then the truly afflicted one is the one who is heedless and forgetful of Allah. As for a believer, as for one who is remembering Allah and doing the right thing at that moment, that person cannot be afflicted. Nothing bad happens to that individual. As the Prophet ﷺ said, it is strange, the matter of the believer, that everything that happens to him is good. And this is only for the believer. This is for no one else but the believer. If he is granted worldly blessings, a pleasing worldly blessing, he becomes grateful, so then it becomes good for him. And if he's afflicted with a worldly calamity, then he is patient, and then even that becomes good for him.
أنتم الآن الرجال أمامي والرجال تشاهدوني تعدون أن رجلا باتت زوجته غضبان عليه مبتلا.
But you men who are in front of me right now and the people who are viewing this class, you think that the one who is afflicted by calamity is the one who is going to bed while his wife is mad at him.
وتعدون أن الحياة الكاملة إذا رضيت الزوجة كما تمثلون في مثالكم الإنجليزي الأسد.
And as you say all the time, happy wife, happy life.
يا أسف على يوسف.
I feel.
No. يا أسف عليكم.
I feel sorry for you guys.
يا أسف رجل.
This is a man.
لا يعد نفسه إذا فقد صلاته وإذا فقد عقيدته وإذا فقد مروءته وإذا فقد حسه الدين لا يعد نفسه مصابا.
Are those the priorities of a man that he would consider himself fine if even if his prayer is lacking and his knowledge is lacking and everything is lacking as long as his wife is happy with him? Forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That his wife is going outside in public, adorned like a fish, and not wearing a hijab and so on. And he does not think that it is an affliction or a trial. His beliefs are corrupted and he does not consider himself. His children do not know anything of the Book of Allah or the language of the Book of Allah and he does not consider himself afflicted.
يلتفت إلى الحمد لله نحن في نعمة من الله سبحانه وتعالى ما شاء الله ما شاء الله عندنا لنا الإيجار الدار وأنت ما شاء الله راضية وأنت تشتغل في المكتب الفلاني وأنا أشتغل في المكتب الفلاني ونحن مسلمون.
So long as the worldly possessions are in his hands, so long as he has money for rent, so long as he can take care of the bills, and take care of his kids in school and so on,
يتفنن في جميع المعاصي.
Despite him being involved in many, many sins,
يتفنن في جميع المعاصي.
And he's involved in all types of sins.
أقلها حمل الأولاد إلى مدارس الكفار.
And the least of his sins is taking his kids to be taught by the disbelievers in public schools.
الحمد لله نحن عائلة مسلمة ما شاء الله بخير ما شاء الله. أنت عندك العمل في المكتب الفلاني وأنا عندي العمل والأولاد نعطوا وظيفة الجامعة والهاي سكول عنهم ما شاء الله. ماذا تشعرين؟ أشعر جيدا ما شاء الله نحن عائلة مسلمة.
And he thinks he's successful. He turns to his wife who's working and he who's working, and then their kids who are thrown away at school. And oh, alhamdulillah, we're making so much money. And the disbelievers in that school are teaching them, brainwashing them day and night. And even the Muslim speakers are brainwashing the adults day and night. And the man turns to his wife and he says, look, alhamdulillah, look how blessed we are. We're such a wonderful family. We're such a lovely bunch of, mashallah.
هذا هو اللي قال الكمل انكم انتم هم المبتلون هذه هي البليه
This is who the
اللهم عافنا
knowers of Allah سبحانه وتعالى
انا عندما اراكم في هذه الحاله اقول اللهم عافنا الحمد لله الذي عافاني مما ابتلاكم به وفضلني على كثير مما خلق تفضيلا اللهم عافنا ولا تبتلنا
This is the state of being
عندما اراه اقول اللهم عافنا هذا هو اللي نطلب الله العافيه منه نسال الله العافيه
This is what I myself when I see I say, may Allah protect me, O Allah protect me and grant me safety from these people's delusions. That is heedlessness at its core. That is the distance from the Lord of the worlds. That is the displeasure and anger of the Lord of the worlds. This is the sign of anger from your Lord. And every time he gets promoted and starts earning more money, goes to a different job, a better job. Oh, I'm getting, you know, that job is scouting me right
now.
The great success that my child was accepted to Stanford or Berkeley. That our daughter is getting a roommate in Davis. That look, mashallah, how blessed we are. While she's with her boyfriend in Davis. And while their son is with his girlfriend in Berkeley. And this is the least harmful possibility. This is the least. Drinking alcohol with a boyfriend, girlfriend. If he did not publicly leave Islam.
وهذا يقال له ما تقول سي سي كان شباب المسلمين في
MSA and they say oh he's in the Muslim Student Association that's
هذا الكفار student هذا الكفار student هؤلاء المنافقين student السلام عليكم هؤلاء الطلاب المنافقون مزورون على الإسلام
these subhanAllah are the fake Muslim students these are the hypocrite students of America
أنت بنفسك كم جربت منهم من هو شاك وكم جربت منهم من هو لا يعلم لا إله إلا الله أنت بنفسك.
That you yourself, the translator, you have seen how many of them that are doubting their Islam, how many of them are changing their Islam, how many of them are doubtful, don't even know a single word of in Islam of لا إله إلا الله.
أنت قلت لي هذا.
نعم.
صحيح أم لا؟
نعم.
أنت أخبرتني بذلك.
عادة من الوالدين يكون أول مرة يرى فيها مسلمين في حياته حين يدخل في المساء. أول مرة.
وماذا اللي رأى؟
نعم.
رأى المسلمين؟ أخبرنا.
That I said the first time, some of them, they never learned anything. This is the first time they're exposed to Muslims in their lives. This is something you hear often in MSAs. But really, if they come to the MSA, and MSAs, if they come, you just hit up a random MSA, you're going to see Muslims. With the Islam that MSAs have is written, is the M on their shirt. That's what they have of Islam, is the M that's on their shirt.
القلب ليس مسلم والجوارح ليست مسلمة والقول ليس مسلم لكن القميص مسلم.
The heart is not in submission to Allah. The heart is not a Muslim. The tongue is not a Muslim.
والأعمال ليست مسلم.
The actions aren't the actions of a Muslim, but the shirt says Muslim.
هذا القميص مسلم ومن يلبس القميص كافر.
The shirt says Muslim, but the one who's wearing the shirt is not a Muslim.
الآية صحيح؟ أخبرنا الخبر.
نعم نعم كثير من المراد نعم.
أخبرنا الخبر. أنت نويت كنت في ديفيس، هذا صحيح أم لا؟
نعم.
أنت كنت في الجامعة الفلانية إخلاص، تعرف أن هذا صحيح أم لا؟ أخبرنا بالإنجليزي. أنت في أي جامعة كنت؟ أنت في أي جامعة كنت؟ هل هذا صحيح أم لا؟
The brother who went to Davis said, yes, this is the case. The brother who went to Cal Poly said that this is the case. And you went to Davis yourself, the translator. Tell us what you saw. I'll tell you what I saw in Davis. I'll tell you what I saw in Berkeley. I'll tell you what I saw in Stanford. You think I didn't go to these universities? I saw all of them. I'm from the desert. But at least I can tell the difference between believers and non-believers. I know what the difference is between a believer and a non-believer. This is a distinction that I can make in detail.
أقول لكم من يشك في وجوب الصلاة من يشك في وجوب الطهارة من يشك في وجوب تعلم الفرض لا مسلم.
I'll tell you the one who doubts the validity or the necessity of prayer, the one who doubts the necessity of fasting and purification. Can this person be considered a Muslim? The one who believes that obligatory Islamic knowledge is not necessary to learn, how can this be a Muslim? The one who thinks that Muslims are truly free in this earth. Can you think that this person is a Muslim, one who submits as a slave to Allah?
كم ترون من شباب المسلمين وكبارهم يعتقدون هذا أن الإسلام حرية.
How often do you see that from the youth to the adults who think that Islam
كبار الشائبين
Islam gives freedom to do whatever you want, believe whatever you want.
ياري تختار.
That you have a choice after you submit yourself to Allah.
هذا كفر صريح.
That this is a clear blasphemy and disbelief. Have you understood the meaning of the hadith that was narrated by Ibn Abi Shayba and Al-Hakim and Al-Dhahabi? That there will come a time where the people gather and flock to the masjids, filling the masjids day and night, but not amongst them is a single believer. But don't worry, they have a shirt that says MSA. And they have a nice white hat. And on Friday they dress in traditional clothes. That yes, those are Islamic traditional clothes, but the people wearing them are not believers according to the Prophet ﷺ.
ترك التعلم لكفر مفضي أو هو كفر عندهم بالمحض ترك ليس أنه يقال أنه ليس واجبا هذا فرق كبير ترك التعلم فقط لكفر مفضي أو هو كفر عندهم بالمحض
The abandonment of seeking knowledge stopping seeking knowledge not seeking knowledge abandoning the act of seeking knowledge is mentioned by the scholars, a difference of opinion. Is it disbelief in itself? Does it take you out of Islam on its own? Or does it lead to disbelief? So then the abandonment of knowledge either is disbelief in itself or leads to disbelief. Why? They said because it is turning away from the prophetic revelation. It is turning away from that revelation that the Prophet ﷺ came and taught us. And if you're turning away from learning the message of the Prophet ﷺ, then the Qur'an describes you as a disbeliever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he who turns away from my remembrance, he will have a miserable existence. And we will resurrect him on the day of judgment blind. These are the descriptions of the believer or the disbeliever. These are the descriptions of the disbeliever.
الذي تسلمت عنه على تكفير خاص وأما أوصافه يا وصف الإنسان هذه أوصاف وصفها الله.
As for this brother right here, he is asking about us making judgment upon others, saying that they are disbelievers upon any individual. That's not our business. But these are the descriptions of the disbelievers for you to look at yourself and to beware. I've given you the descriptions. I'm not putting you on those scales of the Sharia. I'm giving you the scales. I'm not judging any individual. I'm not your Lord, nor am I your prophet. I am not your Lord, nor am I your prophet, nor am I your judge or your master or your leader, your political leader. You are responsible for yourselves. But I'm equipping you with the scales so that once you go home and you go to your room, you can hold yourself to account and you can put yourself on the scale that was offered to you. Maybe you would never wake up from that sleep. That people, they pass away in their sleep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every time a person sleeps, the souls leave the body. So a person could come back to life by waking up, or a person could stay dead. So hold yourself to account. Are you one of the people who was described with any of the descriptions of the disbelievers? Don't be deceived. Don't deceive yourself. Being present inside the masjid or being in the center, it doesn't make you a Muslim. Doesn't matter what school you graduated from, Dar al-Arqam or Dar al-Sahaba or Dar al-this or that. Call it the Dar al-Jannah, the home of Jannah. But hold yourself to account on the scales that given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you the one who is described by revelation as being a believer, a disbeliever, or a hypocrite? Or a transgressing and sinful person? I think you should consider yourself lucky if you only find yourself to be extremely sinful. This is a fortune, a blessing. If you're not in doubt in your deen, then alhamdulillah, you're blessed.
Ahlul bala إذا رأيتم فاسألوا الله عافيته والكملوا قد فسروا أهل البلاء بمن غفل عن ربه سبحانه عز وجل.
So the people who are truly afflicted are the people who are heedless of Allah.
فإذا رأيتم فاسألوا الله عافيته.
So if you see those people who are heedless of Allah, then do it. Put this hadith into practice. That you see the people who are afflicted, who have forgotten Allah, then ask Allah for His protection and safety. Especially you see, when you see people who are heedless of Allah, and they think that they are very righteous. And they think they are very close to Allah while they are heedless. They are unaware of Allah's commands and prohibitions. That is the calamity.
يقول ابن الجوزي في صيد الخاطر أعظم المصيبة أن لا تحس بالمصيبة.
Ibn al-Jawzi, he said that the greatest calamity is to be in a calamity while not knowing you're in a calamity.
مصاب ولا تدري أنك مصاب.
That you're afflicted without knowing you're afflicted.
ولا بل تعتقد أنك ناجح.
But you think in fact that you're successful.
نحن الآن عندما نأتي المساجد في كاليفورنيا أو في أمريكا أو في مثلا نقول ما إن شاء الله كم يدخل المسجد من الناس؟ 10,000 ما شاء الله المسلمين هنا متقدمون.
What's the first question people ask about a new masjid? They say, oh, how many people come here?
10,000.
Oh, 10,000. Wow, what a great place.
لكن هاي 10,000 لا ندري ما هو حالها.
But this 10,000, Allah only knows what their state is.
قطعا 10,000 شخص ولكن
yeah sure it's 10,000
وأهل الجمعة أهل الجمعة
but of course 10,000 on جمعة only
وأهل الجمعة أيضا ثلاث جمعة ثلاث جمعة
and it's not even one جمعة it's three جمعات
مسجدنا ثلاث جمعة
oh you know brother we have so many people coming that our masjid has to have three جمعات
لا يسع الناس
one جمعة is not enough
لا بد أن نجعل جمعة ثانية للناس اللي تعمل
The masjid can't fit everybody in one jum'ah, so instead of making more masjids like they should, no, we'll have more jum'ahs in one masjid for some reason. And oh, people, no, actually, forget about even we have space, but you know, some people work at different times and they get their breaks at different times. We have to accommodate by changing the time of jum'ah. By not changing the time, no problem. By adding more jum'ahs.
قبل دخول الظهر وجمعه في اول وقت دخول الجمعه وجمعه متاخره
by making one congregation before the time even entered somehow and then another congregation on time and then one after it
حسب العمل حسب العمال
because people have different schedules
في الدكاتره ما يفرغون الا في الثالثه وفي من
didn't you know that we have doctors coming to our masjid We have to accommodate. Because they're not going to be free until 3 o'clock. The taxi drivers have to come before the rush. Because the one who is unfortunately like me that he doesn't have any He doesn't have any job, he'll let him come on time. He doesn't have to come earlier or later. No problem, three groups. And whoever opposes this way, he's a criminal. You know the story, you were there, me, the translator, that there was a man who came to visit a sheikh and he's an administrator of one of the biggest masjids in the area. That fits 10,000 or more people. Three jum'ahs in that place. And this guy is the administrator.
وأخبرنا أن بعض التبرعات تكون مليون دولار في شيك واحد.
And he said, you know, we get $1 million donations in one check.
أتعلمون ما هو عمل هذا المدير؟
Do you know what he does, this administrator?
جاءني هذا المدير قال انه يريدنا ان نحضر افطار لمختلف ما يسمونه مختلف الديانات.
He came to my house.
18 في رمضان.
And he invited me. He said, you know, about maybe the 18th in Ramadan or in the middle of Ramadan, we're having an iftar, and it's going to be an interfaith iftar.
ما هو جوابك أنت له؟
قال سيكون هناك رئيس ال the mayor is going to be there. He said the police department.
ما هو جوابك أنت؟ أنا سكت.
I الشيخ didn't say anything. Just. To treat the person at his level, to treat the person kindly at his level, but for me, I was holding myself, and I told him, brother, I don't think Sheikh is going to be interested in coming. You're trying to tempt him, telling him the mayor is coming there. I don't think that's going to motivate him more. Even if Umar ibn Abdul Aziz was visiting that masjid, I wouldn't come to that masjid. I wouldn't meet him in that masjid.
لأنه مسجد أسس على الخراب يعني.
Because it is a masjid that is not founded on piety, it's founded on nonsense.
مهم قال لنا هذا فأبو بكر أجابه قال ما أعتقد أن فلان سيأتي هناك ما أعتقد أنه سيأتي هناك ما أعتقد أنه سيأتي قال لا أنا رجل يعني متسف أنا شاد أمري أنا شاد أمري في الدين أنا.
So, serious. So Abu Bakr told him that I don't think Sheikh is going to be interested in coming. And he said, no, I'm a very serious man. Everybody in my masjid knows that, mashallah, how serious I am. I got a handle on things in the masjid. Everybody knows I got a handle on things. You know how?
ما هو الدليل؟
What's my proof that I'm really serious?
قتل نفس بغير حق شرعي.
I was about to kill a man in the masjid.
بغير حق شرعي.
For no reason.
اسمع. هذا مدير مسجد تبرعوا عليه بمليون بعض الشيك واحد في ثلاث جمع. الدليل على أنه مستقيم أنه سيقتل نفسه بغير حق ويدعو إمير البقاء.
This is all you need to know. An administrator of a masjid that has, mashallah, three jum'as. And هم لا
يسووا كلمة
نعم. That has three jum'as. And inviting me to this type of gathering and proving that he's serious because he, mashallah, was about to kill somebody in the masjid.
المهم اسمعوا حتى تكونوا على علم ما يقع.
So listen just so you know what's going on.
وانتم ما شاء الله ايضا تعلمون ما تعلمون اضافة الى علمكم.
And this is what you know. This is ما شاء الله.
فقط افيدكم ازيدكم ما عندكم ما شاء الله علمكم.
You know how these ما شاء الله masjid these people are generally.
ما شاء الله تعلمون ما تعلمون لكن ازيدكم.
You know what you know. I'll just give you some more info.
قال نحن نصلي ثلاث جمعة وهناك رجل يعارض في ذلك يقول دائما لماذا تصلون ثلاث جمعة هذا ما عنده حق شرعي لماذا
He said, you know how I'm serious? There's this guy who used to come to our masjid and we pray three jum'as and he came and he started talking about, you know, it's not valid to pray jum'as and there's no Islamic proof for three jum'as and in Islamic history people have never done three jum'as and three jum'as is not from Islam.
Sultan.
It's an innovation, there's no proof for it in Islam.
فاستمر دائما يعارض في الأمر فقال له دع عنك الأمر الأمر أمري هو الأمر أمري أنا.
So then I told him, look, this is not your business, this is my business, just stay out of this is not your business. Just stop talking about this.
لا تتدخل فيما لا يعنيك.
Don't mind your own business.
المهم أنه استمر على فأخذه بمجامع ثوبه وأخرجه من المسجد وهزه هناك.
He said then he kept on going and going about this three jum'as is not valid thing. He said until I took him out of the masjid, I dragged him out with his clothes and I threatened him.
احذر من أن تقولها مرة ثانية.
And I threatened him, you better not say this again.
طيب لا أتكلم فيها.
So he said okay, I'm going to stop.
فتوقف لمدة.
And he stopped for a while. But after that, he thought about it some more, and he came back to telling people that three jum'as is not valid. So then the administrator overheard him talking about this while he was praying witr.
وحنفي حسن ما يقول وليس حنفي
حسن. Anyways. And wizard is required according to the Hanafis.
طبعاً هو ليس حنفي هو فقط كلام.
But although the
message was Hanafi. هذه فقط دعاوى.
But these are claims that people make. People just ascribe titles to themselves without any reality.
غضب وقطع الوتر.
So he got so mad he cut off his prayer in the middle of it.
وأخذ كرسيا كامل.
He said I cut off my prayer in the middle of it and I grabbed a chair.
قال انت تكلمت بهذا مره ثانيه فهذا اخر نفسك.
He said I raised the chair over his head and I told him if you talk about this one more time this is the last breath you will breathe.
هذه اخر نفس.
This is your last breath.
فسكت المخاصم.
He said and that's it, nobody talked about the topic again.
انتهى الامر قضي الامر الذي فيه تستفتيان.
They know I'm serious.
هذا قضاء يوسف عليه السلام.
That's it, that's all. That's it. You know the matter you're asking about is sealed and done. So I was amazed by the level of corruption on top of corruption.
طبعاً أبو بكر كان يضحك والجميع الناس ولكن تعجبت من الفساد.
Yes, of course, I was sitting there confused at the level of nonsense that this guy is saying, and while Abu Bakr, the translator, is standing there and laughing, I couldn't stop laughing because, and he saw me laughing. وقال لي أنا أعلم أن هذا خطأ بعد أن رأني أضحك. فلا أقره في أمره فقال أنا أعلم أني خاطئ ولكن الناس يعلمون أني يعني serious. That once he saw me laughing, that means I wasn't playing along with what he was saying, that this is complete nonsense. And he doesn't even know half of why I'm laughing. But then he saw me laughing that I wasn't agreeing with what he did. He said, no, I know I was wrong in doing and threatening this man's life, but at least people in the message know I'm a serious person right now. Did that make me laugh more?
هذا المدير اللي ترجع للإمام يوقره ويقوم له والإمام قال لنا بنفسه قال الإمام لا يقبل خروجه من المسجد أصلا. عرض عليهم الخروج مرات والإمام قال لا لن نقبل إلا أنت.
That he said that not only am I, mashallah, respected in the masjid, the imam, you know, we have a great relationship, and I was about to leave and stop being the administrator a few times, but each time the imam insists and he says, you're the only guy that can lead us. That you're the only one who can lead us. So how is the imam going to answer the Lord of the worlds? What can the imam say to Allah when Allah asks him about that statement of his? He said, no one can be the administrator but you. What kind of nonsense qualifies this person to be the administrator? That he was threatening people's lives? That he's praying three invalid jum'ahs?
هذا هو الذي لا يصلح للإدارة غيره بسبب أنه يفعل قتل الأنفس ويخالف الإجماع.
And then he's subhanAllah going against consensus and making mashallah three jum'ahs or threatening people's lives.
هذا الإمام ومشهور هذا فعله لا أريد أن أسميه مشهور.
But the Imam of course is famous in the Bay Area and I don't want to name his name.
الإمام لا يقبل خروجه. لا هو الذي أخبرنا قال لا يحترمني عندما يراني يقف ويسلم علي وخصوصيتي خاصة ويقول لا لن نقبلك تخرج.
Then he says once the Imam sees me he greets me and we have a great relationship and he insists that I stay as the administrator of the masjid.
أقول من الناس لا يصلح الإمارة إلا هم.
That he says to the people that nobody can be our leader except for that man. Listen to your imams. These are your imams and these are your administrators.
Imam يقول لا يصلح للإدارة غيرها والمدير يرفض أن يتكلم في ثلاث جمعة وفي الخاتمة يقول سيقتلون نفسا بغير حق شرعي يتكلم فيها.
الإمام
لا يقبل غير هذا الشخص.
That the only person the Imam, mashallah, thinks is fit to be a leader for the masjid is the one who threatens people and who has three jum'ahs and invites the mayor.
سيقتل نفسا بغير حق شرعي في وسط مسجد.
He's about to kill somebody in the middle of the masjid.
هذا هو أدل دليل على الاستقامة.
That he is using as the proof of his uprightness and his strength that I was about to kill a man in the masjid.
ألا أنه قال كلمة حق.
And that man, why was he killing him? Because the man was telling him the truth. You can't have three jum'ahs.
قال كلمة حق فقط.
He was telling him a true statement and that's it.
قال إن تكلمت في هذا فهذه آخر نفس وخلاص.
He said if you keep saying this, that's the last breath you'll breathe.
والجميع ما إن شاء الله راضوا المسجد سيكون مملوء من الناس إن شاء الله. أنا أعتقد أنها في رمضان لا أدري ولكن.
And everybody else is happy, of course. No, alhamdulillah, now the problem is done. We can fill our masjid three times in Jum'ah.
هذا هم أهل البلاء. هذا أسأل الله عافيته. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا وفي الآخرة وأن تحفظنا من مصاحبة هؤلاء الناس وأن تحفظنا من جلود هؤلاء الناس وأن تبعدنا من هؤلاء الناس وأن لا تجعلنا صحبة بهؤلاء الناس وأن لا تقربنا من هؤلاء الناس وأن لا تجعلنا ودا في هؤلاء الناس وأن لا تجعلنا علاقة بهؤلاء الناس.
Oh Allah, do not make us like those people, do not make us close to those people, do not make those people beloved to us, and do not make us resemble those people. Those are the people of heedlessness. Those you'll see are doctors who are immigrants and engineers in their 60s and 70s. That now their business is what? Taking leadership roles in masjids.
هذا هو عندكم الخبر اليقين وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ويبدو أن الدرس طال ولو استفدنا هذه الفائدة فقط لكفانا ذلك وسنصلي العشاء وأودعكم وأراكم غدا إن شاء الله.
So I say this statement of mine and I ask Allah's forgiveness for all of us. And it looks like this topic on its own was long enough. So inshallah we will end here and I bid farewell to you. Inshallah we'll begin our class tomorrow again at 9:30. And I seek Allah's forgiveness for all of us. Any questions? Yeah.
I have a question now.
No.
I have three questions.
No.
What makes a land of Islam and what makes a land of kufr?
Hmm. That's it, no problem, inshallah.
Barakallahu fiik.
May Allah bless you.
Ahsan. Excellent. أسهل جواب موجود.
The easiest answer.
أولاً هذه الأرض أرض كفر.
First of all, this is a non-believing land, this is a land of kufr.
ولكن ما هو معنى أرض كفر؟
But what does land of kufr mean?
قلنا هل موريتانيا أرض إسلام وهل مالي أرض إسلام وهل السعودية أرض إسلام؟
Tell me, is Mali a Muslim country, a land of Islam, or is Mauritania or Saudi Arabia or Egypt?
من هم الحكام هنا؟
Who are the leaders there?
هؤلاء ترامب.
Those are Trump's, workers.
أين أرض الإسلام؟
So where is this land of Islam? That's a different thing entirely.
المهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبر أن في آخر الزمان هذه الأرض سينتفي منها الإسلام.
The important thing is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam indicated to us that in this land that Islam will be hard to find in the end times.
قال بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا فطوبى للغرباء. أنتم لا تؤمنون بالغيب. هذه المشكلة الكبيرة جدا. هذا ليس غيب. هذا صار واقعا.
That Islam began as something strange, he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam began as something strange, and will return to be strange like it began. So what does that mean then? This means that subhanAllah you don't believe in the unseen, but this statement when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it was unseen, but today is seen with your own eyes. So do you deny what you see in front of your own eyes? That ask the Afghans, there's like 20 of them, mashallah. Ask the Libyans, this is a Libyan and his mother is Egyptian.
كم يخرج من المسلمين من الإسلام في هذه البلاد يوميا؟
How many people daily leave Islam in those countries? How many people, subhanAllah, I was doing talking to somebody in Egypt. I didn't know who he was.
وفي ليبيا وفي موريتانيا وفي 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 وفي.
وكان طالب في الأزهر. طالب قال لي أن هذه الأجوبة سبحان الله ما جاوبها لنا في الأزهر وكثير من أصحابي تركوا الإسلام. He told me many of my friends have left Islam in Al-Azhar. After he asked his questions and I answered them, I didn't know who he was. He said, oh, I'm a student at Al-Azhar University. And these questions that you answered, he said, some guy is telling people
this nonsense. ومفتي الأزهر العام ماذا يقول؟ يقول بفناء النار.
He said, my friends have left Islam. And of course, that's no surprise because the Mufti of Al-Azhar,
مفتي بصر العام الأكبر مفتي.
The great, the grand Mufti of Egypt and the leader of who is also the leader of Al-Azhar. What did you see with your own eyes him saying? He said that hellfire will end. He said, yes, hellfire contains types of mercy and of refreshment and that hellfire will end.
That
he was promoting those beliefs without saying he believes in them. And what disbelief is there over this? And there are so-called muftis from Mauritania who say that there is more than one Abrahamic faith. These are so-called Muslim lands. And how many people literally are ascribing a body to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bringing down Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala literally, that is saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes up and down, down. Who call themselves Muslims in Saudi Arabia. In Saudi Arabia.
So
this is the land of the two holy mosques. So tell me, where do we find the Muslims? Who has the power in the land right now, the leadership in the land? The Muslims are the disbelievers. But the land truly belongs to Allah, that He inherits it to whomever He wills of His servants, believers or otherwise. At this moment, He has inherited it to the disbelievers. What can we do?
يوشك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يوشك أن تتداعى عليكم الأمم كما تتداعى الأكلة على قصعتها قالوا أو من قلة يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا ولكن غذاء كغذاء السيل.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said it will very soon be that the nations will gather against you and take from you as easily as.
هذا واضح.
And you say the United Nations, what's going on to the Muslims? That they will take from you as easily as people take from a plate of food. And the companions said, really, would this be because we are few in number, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet ﷺ said, no, you'd rather be very many. You'll be very many. But you will be useless like the foam of the sea, like the scum on top of the ocean.
الأجوبة عندكم من رسول رب العالمين أجوبة موجودة.
So the answer is given to you by the Lord of the worlds and the Messenger of the Lord of the worlds.
لكن لا تقبلوها.
But you do not accept it.
حتى تريدون تجعلوا أمريكا أرض إسلام.
That you try to make America, mashallah, a Muslim country.
أما بالنسبة للجمعة فهذا البلد يختلف العلماء فيه هل تجب فيه الجمعة أو لا تجب.
So as far as the obligation of Jum'ah in America, there's a difference of opinion amongst the scholars whether the Jum'ah is required or not required in this land.
فمذهب أبي حنيفة النعماني أنها لا تصح ولا توجد في بلاد أمريكا.
The مذهب of Abu Hanifa himself.
الإمام الأعظم التابعي النعمان.
The follower of the companions Abu Hanifa النعمان. He said, no, it is not required. That there must be a Muslim leader who establishes that Jum'ah for the Jum'ah to be required and valid. If there's no Sultan, there's no Jum'ah. And is there a Muslim Sultan in the Muslim lands today? So what do you think in America? That was the madhab of Imam Abu Hanifa, that's it. The Hanafis will for sure tell you that that's not true. But that is the madhab of Abu Hanifa. Forget about those who call themselves Hanafis. This
was
the statement of Abu Hanifa himself.
هذا هو فتوى أبو حنيفة.
That was the fatwa of Abu Hanifa.
فتوى من يقول أنه حنفي أنا لا أسأل عنه.
I'm not asking about the people who call themselves Hanafis today.
أنا أريد أبو حنيفة بنفسه.
I want Abu Hanifa's fatwa himself.
أما مالك فقال إذا وجدت الشروط وكان هناك مسجد مبني وقف كامل للمسلمين وقبلة صحيحة ووجدت الشروط فيمكن أن يصلوها.
As for Imam Malik, he has said that if the conditions of Jum'ah are met and the conditions of the masjid are met, that it is fully a building that is owned by no one, that is an endowment for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing, there is no debt on that masjid. It is 100% dedicated permanently for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولو الناس كانت فقط 12 رجلا موجودة والأمن موجود كافي.
And you have safety, and you have at least 12 male residents. Then you pray Jum'ah. Then the Jum'ah becomes obligatory upon them. If there is safety, and alhamdulillah, we do live in safety. As for Imam Malik, 12 متوطن.
نعم.
That and as for Imam Shafi'i, he said the same, but it has to be 40 residents, male residents who live in that town. After that, then it is between you and the fuqaha, the scholars of this ummah. هذا الأخ يسأل سؤال كان يرفع يده من زمان.
تفضل.
Yes, brother Talib.
ما هو السؤال؟
هو هل
اسأل في الإنجليزي.
So the brother is asking, today obviously you don't know who's a real scholar, you don't know who's a fake scholar, most of them are fake scholars, your YouTube is filled with a bunch of nonsense, you can't trust anything on there, and then we're supposed to look for people in person who can teach us, but that's very hard to find, and sometimes harder to distinguish. So then what do you do? Do you go to the books themselves, the old original books, or what do you do? That is blindness and deafness and dumbness.
ذهاب إلى علماء فيسبوك عمى وصم وبكم والذهاب إلى البوكس يعني أيضا عصمى وعمى.
It is deaf, dumb, and blindness to go to YouTube or to go to books on your own.
بدأ الإسلام غريبا بحث عن الغرباء حتى تجده.
Islam began as something strange and it will remain to be strange.
الغرباء بحث عن من طوبى لهم.
It will return to be strange like it began. So look for the strangers. Look, never give up. Look for those who can actually teach you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides. Allah provides.
الكتب ما يمكن واحد يقرأ منها. إذا لبت العلوم بغير شيخ ضللت عن الصراط المستقيم.
If you go after the books without a teacher, you will be led astray from the straight path.
وتنطمس العلوم عليك حتى تكون أضل من توم الحكيم.
And you will become confused by the different sciences, by the different knowledge, until you become more misguided than توم الحكيم.
توم الحكيم كان الطبيب يقرأ الكتب الحكمة. الطبية من الكتب العربية القديمة وكان لا يخطأ دائما.
توم الحكيم was a healer who used to heal people based on reading the books of medicine.
وطبيب حكيم جدا.
And he was very known as a very strong healer.
لكن يأخذ علمه من الكتب.
But his knowledge was from the books.
يومئذ مع فهمه ومعرفته بالحكمة. قرأ في كتاب الحبة السوداء تشفي من الرمى فإذا هي نقطة الحية السوداء تشفي من الرمى.
And one time he was reading those books and trying to cure somebody of a cataract.
أرمل.
I believe a cataract, some eye disease.
وجع بالعين.
Some pain in his eye. And he found in the book that it said the black seed is a cure for those things. So then, but what he read in the book, there was an extra dot by, instead of habba, it became hayya, it became a ya instead of a ba, which translates to the black snake cures from that disease. So he got a black snake. And he put the poison, he took the poison out of the snake and put it in the eye of that man to cure his problem, and he made the man blind. These are the book guys. These are the speakers on Facebook and YouTube, and you'll be the same if you go after books without a proper teacher.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبركم أن الكتب لا تهدي بنفس الحديث الصحيح وفسره العلماء وهذا ما هو كلامي.
This is not my speech. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has warned you about this.
قال إن الله لا يقبض العلم انتزاعا ينتزعه من صدور العباد ولكن يقبضه بموت العلماء. ما قال بحرق الكتب وما قال بفقد مكتبة الإسلامية. لا مكتبة الإسلامية موجودة.
The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah will not snatch away knowledge by taking it from the hearts of His servants, but He will take it away by the death of the scholars. Once no scholar remains, people will take as their leaders ignorant heads. The books will remain. Allah will not take the knowledge away from the books. The Islamic library will still remain. The books will not be burned, but the scholars pass away. So that means that misguidance will be found along the side of the books. The cause for misguidance is ignorance and books. The books are widespread and being printed at an unprecedented rate nowadays. Translated into every language on the face of the earth. Arabic and English and Spanish and Farsi. And the types of ignorant people who own and read these books, only Allah knows.
هذا هو سبب الضلال والفساد.
That is the cause of misguidance
and corruption.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that once no scholar remains, the people will take as their leaders ignorant heads, and they will ask them, and they will give them their opinion without knowledge. They can have access to the books, they read the books, but their ignorance remains and their misguidance grows. The Prophet ﷺ said that they will misguide themselves and others. They will misguide themselves with books, and they will give certificates to people after that and misguide the world.
طيب جواب موجود تفضل لان فيها الايمان الفاجره وفيها البيوعات الفاسده وفيها اجتماع الفساد كله.
So you heard that the most beloved place to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the masjid. Other than, of course, the masjids of today. And the most hated place to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the marketplace. So why is the marketplace the most hated? It is because it grows the love and attachment to every type of corruption. There's false swearing. People swear. All the types of corruption are gathered. That people swear falsely. People seek things by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left and right. And interest and every type of evil. Betrayal, cheating, deception, forgery, fraud. Of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love any of this.
المساجد طبعا هاي محل العبادة.
The masjids, the true masjids, of course, those are the places of worship and of teaching knowledge. Of course, they are the most beloved places to Allah. Yeah. Final question. قال قال الشيخ أن الناس يضلون في بيركلي وستانفورد وديفيس في الـMSA فهل يكون أفضل لهم أن يذهبوا لمدرسة حمزة يوسف؟
أنا لا أجيب عن مخصص ولكن لم أرى جامعات إسلامية طبعا.
I do not talk about specific places to target specific people. And I talked to you about this morning, but I do not know of any Islamic university here.
ما دخلت الزيتونة.
I have not entered into that Zaytuna.
لا أعرف
مكانها الآن. I have not entered the new Zaytuna. I don't know where it is.
ولا أعرف دار العلوم في شيكاغو.
Nor have I gone to دار العلوم شيكاغو.
ولكني لا أثق بالجامعة الإسلامية في المدينة المنورة.
But if I do not trust the Islamic university in Medina.
ما بقي في أيديكم.
Then what about what's in front of you here?
واضح؟
Clear.
There's a question online.
Okay.
It's about when you were speaking about the masajid having three different times of Friday prayers.
Yeah.
So this person is asking a question that we live in a system that is not designed around Islam. So what's the solution? You gave us a solution under the circumstances.
أتكلمنا عن سلوشن اليوم صباحا قل يرجع إلى الدرس الفرق
go
بين الإسلام العرفي والإسلام الوحي.
Go into a class this go to this morning's class. The difference between cultural Islam and Islam based on revelation. هل يكون يعني يعني نعم نعم.
لا بد أن يعني الإسلام الوحي ما في جمعة ثانية ولا ثالثة والجمعة لها شروط كغيرها من الصلوات ولا يحل له أن يفعل فعلا حتى يعلم حكم الله فيه والإسلام العرفي شيء آخر.
So then it is not permissible to do any action. This is a matter of consensus that it is not permissible to do any action until you know Allah's ruling in it. It is not valid in Islam to have multiple Jum'ahs in a place. This is something that is fabricated and innovated due to a claim of necessity.
But
in revelation, the Islam based on culture, this is absolutely what people will do. The Islam based on revelation, this is not something that was revealed to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No second and third Jum'ah, and no action accepted until you know Allah's ruling in it.
The question is about the living in the system that's against Islam. It's designed, it's not designed by Islam.
Yeah. يقول أن في 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 مكان يعني كل شيء يعني الجدول الناس للشغل وكل الأمور ليست مبنية على الإسلام.
هذا قلناه.
Yeah, this is exactly what Sheikh is addressing. That the system is based on the culture here.
أنا مشكلتي إن نقول مثلا مليار مرة بعد أسأل عنها.
And convenience and so on and people change the rulings to fit the culture. And the problem is I talk about something a billion times and people still ask about it. The Muslim has no choice. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a command, they do it and that's it. Something that will prevent you from praying. Are you going to keep on that thing that's preventing you from praying? Something that's going to bar you from having your proper Islamic belief. Should you hold on to it and hang on to it? Okay. And then it should be obvious. أظن هم يبنون يفعلون هذا لأنهم يريدون التبرعات في مسجد واحد فبدل أن يبنوا مصليات أخرى أو مساجد أخرى
أنا لا أنصح بمسجد واحد ولا بمساجد. أنا إذا سألني أحد نقوله لا تدخل مسجدا لا واحدا ولا اثنين ولا أربعة ولا عشرين. وإذا لم يسألني فهو حسبه الله تعالى.
based on our state of affairs, you know, you have to understand the situation you're in and take that in context. Inshallah, the context is available in the class of this morning.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا تقوم الساعة إلا على أشرار الناس حتى لا يقال لا إله
The day of judgment will not come except upon the worst of people until La ilaha illallah is no longer said. يقول في هذا الزمان يعني وصعب أن تجد من يعلمك يعني وبعض الناس ما عندهم فلأي درجة هو عليه أن يبحث على معلم
أقل شيء أن يبحث كما يبحث عن الدكتورة أو عن الهندسة أو عن عيشه اليوم
So the brother is asking to what extent you have to look for that proper teacher At the very least The extent of which you give to something that is a lower priority, which is your degree that you put in. How many years? Your daily living. How many hours did you put in to your job? How many years did you spend getting your degree? 20 years?
Salman al-Farisi, كم بحثه وبلال
ابن Salman al-Farisi, how have you heard his story? How many years was he searching? For the proper teacher.
بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير ما أبقى.
But you prefer this worldly life, and you'll put it as a priority
بحث
first.
بحث المعلم صحيح. ما لا نفعل. بل إذا جاءنا نتهرب منه.
But if it's not immediately convenient, then looking for a right teacher, that's too hard. And if we receive one in front of our face. Will run away.
Right?
How much have you taken advantage of an opportunity that was presented?
بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى.
هل هذا قول الإمام مالك إن سبحان الله من تعلم العلم وعلم بما عمل؟
هذا هو القول مالك فيها الطريقة والحقيقة والشريعة.
This was the statement of Imam Malik then answering this question that he said a very strong statement subhanAllah that gathered between the sharia, the tariqah and the haqiqah, the reality that he said whoever acts upon that which they know that they learned to the capacity, they had the opportunity, whatever small opportunity, whatever little bit of knowledge they had, they fully put it into practice. Then Allah will teach them that which they do not know. Allah will provide.
La ilaha
سؤال أخير أم خلاص؟
طيب.
عمر.
يا عمر تعالى بسم الله.
قال الله يبدي ولا يبتدي هذا شيء يعني هو فقط من هذه الرؤيا أم هل هذا المعنى موجود؟
هو الواقع قالها الله تعالى بيّنتها لكم من القرآن الحكيم.
تلك
الأيام نداولها بين الناس تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك من أنا وضحتها لكم من القرآن.
There are many verses that indicate this aqidah point that Allah makes apparent different things and the matters of each day that become apparent that were already willed and created by Allah. That Allah alternates the times amongst the people. Those are all verses that explain.
That you give the leadership,
you give the
kingdom.
Honor, life, health, wealth, poverty, sickness, everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to whomever He wills, takes from whomever He wills. that he makes apparent. So this statement of the Prophet ﷺ in the dream of that individual is supported, but subhanAllah, the concise way that was said by the Prophet ﷺ to the man in his dream is just a simple way to put that verse, those verses together, subhanAllah. Yeah, obviously, you know, you do not take matters of aqidah from dreams.
قلنا له ان وضحناها له بالادله الشرعيه ولذلك هو توقف الرجل توقف
that we said that it was established by the proofs from the deen from the Quran that's why he stopped that's why he was satisfied with the answer
من له سؤال يسأل انتهينا
Is that sufficient? Inshallah, we're done.
Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzah amma yasifun wa salamun ala mursalin walhamdulillah. Ya qawm, isma'u nasihata an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. My people, O people, listen to the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
تعلموا العلم وتعلموا للعلم السكينة والوقار وتواضعوا لمن تتعلمون منه.
Learn knowledge and apply yourself to gain that knowledge with stillness, silence and humility and humble yourselves to the people that you are learning from.
تعلموا العلم وتعلموا للعلم السكينة والوقار وتواضعوا لمن تتعلمون منه.
And learn knowledge and apply serenity
طبقوه.
And silence to gain that knowledge. Put that knowledge into practice.
العلم ما أكسبت خشية العلي وما خلا منه فجاهل العلم ما أكسب خشية العلي.
Knowledge is what leads you to fearing the exalted.
وما خلا منها فجاهل.
And the one who is absent of fear of Allah, the one who is devoid of fear of Allah is ignorant.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد سيد الأنبياء ونبيهم وخاتم المرسلين وعلى آله وصحابته وأمته أفضل الأمم أجمعين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأهوال والآفات وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات وتطهرنا بها من جميع السجيات وترفعنا بها عندك على الدرجات وتبلغنا بها الصلوات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل صلاة تامة وسلم سلاما تاما على نبي تفرج به الكرب وتزال به الهموم وتدرك به الرغائب وتوضع به الحوائج وتنال به الامال ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى اله واصحابه اصحاب النبي العميم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى اله واصحابه وصل عليه عد ما كنت محصيا صلاه يحاشينا بها القدر المر وتقضى بها حاجاتنا ويماط ما يسوء بها عنا ويسعفنا الدهر ونمن من تلبيس إبليس والهوى ولمارة السوء التي أمرها أمر وتصلح حالينا بها حقنا بها منك إعزاز تأبد والنصر ولا تشمت فينا عدوا وحاسدا ولا شنان حشو أحشائي الجمر بجاه الذي أخبرت للذكر أنه له في المقامات العلا ورفع الذكر محمد المخلوق من بركاته ومن نوره أيوب ورسول نور ولولاه لم تخرج من العدم الدنا وضرتها والعرش واللوح والجسر ولم ترزق الأحياء ولم تكشف البلوى ولم يسعف الدر إلهي 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 كما فضلته متفضلا به علينا فلنا المقت والمكروه إلهي 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 أنت وحدك أرتجي فما لي من زيد سواك ولا عمرو إلهي اكفني همي جميعا وأولني أن أشكر ما فيه علي لك الشكر إلهي لا تفضح بينك بين من خلقت إلهي وما يجمع الحشر إلهي لا تفضح عبيدك بين ما خلقت إلهي يوم يجمع الحشر. إلهي إلهي أنت وحدك أرضي وما لي من زيد سواك ولا عمر إلهي اكفني همي جميعا وأولني أن أشكر ما فيه علي لك الشكر. إلهي إلهي تقبل ما كسبت ولا بما اكتسبت تعاقبني فيسكو لي الأجر. الحمد لله الحمد لله ما في العمر وكافي وزله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. سبحانك رب العزة عما يصفون. السلام على المرسلين.